Unreal Engine is everywhere, from AAA games to indie projects, even film and architecture. But did you know, it all started with Unreal, a 1998 FPS that sold 1.5 million copies. By 2014, Unreal Engine was crowned the most successful game engine ever. But now, people are saying Unreal is killing games. Is that true? Let's take a quick look at Unreal Engine and the controversy surrounding it in this episode of the Engine Archive. It all started with this man, Tim Sweeney, the developer of Unreal Engine. Like other brilliant minds, Tim Sweeney, as a grade schooler, took apart and reassembled a family lawnmower, built his own go-kart, and after visiting his brother's software startup at the age of 11, he was bitten by the coding bug. He began developing his own games but never shared them. However, when he started college, he released his first game, ZZT, a top-down action-adventure game in 1991. But this was no ordinary game. It had a built-in editor and scripting language, allowing ZZT to be used as a development kit for other games. This game was a solid success, earning Sweeney around $100 a day at that time. So, he hired a small team, moved his new business out of his parents' house and renamed it Epic Mega Games. Fast forward to 1998 and he had created the Unreal Engine for that very game Unreal. And in 1999, the company reallocated to North Carolina and eventually became known simply as Epic Games. Unreal Engine is written in C++. It's built to be highly portable, meaning it can run on a wide range of platforms, desktop, consoles, and mobile devices. And it is free until you earn $1 million. After that, Epic charges a 5% revenue share, which is waived for games published exclusively on the Epic Games Store. The latest generation, Unreal Engine 5, launched in April 2022, brought in some revolutionary features. One of these is Nanite, which lets developers use super detailed 3D models with automatic level of detail. Another standout feature is Lumen, a dynamic global illumination solution that creates realistic lighting and reflections in real time. With these tools, you can build environments that look as close to real life as technology currently allows. To get started with Unreal Engine, just download and install the Epic Games Launcher. Head over to the Unreal Engine section and pick the version you like. There are plenty of starter project templates available. Say, if you want to prototype a third-person shooter, you can select that template and boom, you have a project with basic movement, a simple environment, and more ready for you to tinker with. As amazing as Unreal Engine is, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. One of the main issues is that it can be pretty heavy on your computer, especially with Unreal Engine 5 and its advanced features like Nanite. If you don't have a powerful PC with a fast SSD, you might find yourself waiting 20 minutes or more just for your project to load. Trust me on this, I have personally experienced it. Unreal gives you two options on how you code your game. You can either dive into C++ for a more hands-on code-intensive approach, or you can use Blueprints, a visual scripting system that lets you create game logic by simply connecting nodes. This is fantastic for those who might not be comfortable with coding just yet but still want to create complex interactions in their game. It's like having your cake and eating it too. Flexibility is key. Because Unreal is so successful and widely used, there is a fear that it is creating a kind of monopoly, and monopoly is bad for any industry. A monopoly is like a dictatorship in business. It removes competition, limits choices, and gives all the power to a single entity. Developers who say Unreal is killing games aren't claiming that engine itself magically sucks. They are warning that its widespread adoption may lead to homogenization of game design and aesthetics. A lot of big studios are ditching their old in-house game engines because UE5 has features like Nanite and Lumen that can crank out stunning visuals and speed up development. For example, CD Projekt Red decided to swap out their old Red engine for The Witcher 4, so they could tap into these cutting-edge tools. And it's not just them, Halo Studios made a similar move from their custom Slipspace engine to Unreal, partially because keeping up with an aging engine was just too much of a drag. But it's not just about the visuals. Unreal Engine isn't only a creative decision, it is an economic one too. Building our own engine from scratch is super expensive and requires a specialized team. Unreal, on the other hand, comes with a huge ecosystem and a ready pool of talent who already know the ins and outs of its workflow. This means studios can save a ton of time and money, which is always a plus. However, this convenience might also make studios less willing to invest in new innovative technologies that lead to more unique gameplay experiences. So, is Unreal Engine killing games? Personally, I think it's more of a double-edged sword. On one hand, it provides amazing features and efficiency that help bring ambitious projects to life. On the other hand, as more studios abandon their own bespoke technologies in favor of Unreal, the risk is that game will start to look and feel increasingly similar. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. Some games made using Unreal include PUBG Mobile, that I have played for years, Fortnite, and Black Myth: Wukong.